I am Dolos, mistress of deception and
all
trickery.
That remains is your
you
sacrifice.
You are more powerful than he.
Humanity has outstayed its welcome. The dead shall inherit the earth.
Listen to the sound of my voice. Can you hear me?
Who's there? I can't see you.
My name is Dr. Salim. We've met before.
Dr. Salim, where am I?
You have fallen between the world of the living and the dead. The void.
I'm dead? I can't be dead. Deimos, I have to stop him.
And you still can. I'll explain as we...
We'd lost comms with John Taylor's squad. Another undead. Coalescence. Enhance yourself for a better tomorrow. They'd been the forefront of technology, always wanting to improve the individual, the future of you.
What happened? What went wrong?
The coalescence disaster happened. Virus 6115 spread throughout Singapore and strains popped up all over the world. Governments built these quarantine zones to house the undead, a way for the populace to ignore what was happening. 10 years on, and it had worked. We put it out of mind. Ignorance was bliss.
What was so special about this operation?
It was supposed to be by the books. 5 years after our cybernetic augmentations, Hendrix and I were a well-oiled machine. Quarantine sweeps, recon, search and rescue. It's just what dead killers do. But we'd never been sent after one of our own before. John Taylor's systems had gone quiet. With our direct neural interface, we're hardwired into Winslow Accord servers. Observation knew if you were dead or alive. For Taylor to be neither, that was unusual. We located an EMF source and uploaded it to Central. It was a 54 immortal audio log, detailing unusual activity coming from the server room at the lowest level of the building. It couldn't have been more than a week old. Probably why Taylor's team had been sent to investigate. Hendrix activated a recon drone to scan for life. We picked up a signal coming from far below. As we stood there in the atrium, I felt like Alice. And we were about to jump down the rabbit hole. Our drone picked up activity ahead. We should have known we weren't alone down here. When man fled the virus, they left behind thousands of active robots. Machinery abandoned with one directive: kill the dead. Years later, they're still killing. But with decrepit programming, somehow humans had been added to their kill list, indistinguishable from our brainless counterparts. The strange behavior was observed in multiple quarantine zones. Another nuisance for us to deal with while on recon. We moved on. We reached the silo's floor, but the signal came. from lower still, below coalescence.
Did you have any inkling of what waited for you?
No. In hindsight, we should have put it together. But the fact of the matter, that day was supposed to be like any other.
What did you find below coalescence?
A CIA black project. Project Corvus. Unknown to the world, and unknown to most people in the know. As off the record as it got. A redacted footnote in Langley's history book. Part of me wishes we just turned back.
Why?
It would have been easier. For me. For Hendrix. For the world.
Is it such a bad thing to want to be blissfully ignorant in the face of daunting adversity?
We didn't have a choice.
Those who find fate thrust upon them rarely do.
Thank you.
human testing lab. What awaited you there?
We found the truth. The cause of the disaster.
You are certain of this?
We didn't have the full picture. Not yet. But this was the source. We knew coalescence was where the virus originated, but residue of 6150...
When you found the server room, did you have any idea what you would uncover?
We couldn't have known. What we found was... We found Sebastian Diaz. One of Taylor's. Another dead killer. Our friend. He had... He'd linked himself to the CIA server, connected directly with the Winslow Accord systems. He was deactivating defenses for the undead quarantine zones all over the world. The massive walls containing the spread, keeping us from the undead. Deactivating the defenses would let the flesh-eating hordes loose upon the living. It would end humanity. We had to stop him. The only way to stop him now was by destroying the server.
Yes!
You killed him. Your friend.
He left us no choice. Hendrix wasn't happy and let Diaz know that. He'd unleashed the dead upon the world. Hendrix knew what he had to do.
You needed to find out what he knew. What he knew about Taylor.
Interfacing with Diaz and accessing his memories was the only way to find him.
Knowing.
We needed to get out of there before the whole building collapsed. Hendrix had an idea. Flood the lab and let the water pressure jettison us out. Our lungs could take it. He just needed time to open the door.
Thank you.
And what happened then?
We got through it. But we weren't giving up that easy. All right, Salim. I told you how this began. Now tell me why. How do I stop Deimos if I'm dead?
Your body is dead, but your mind remains alive. I'm connected through your direct neural interface in your subconscious. To save humanity, you must open the portal. With your body gone, the only way to do this is to train your mind.
Train my mind?
Relive the events preceding your last. Only then can you alter them, change them.
This... Now this is insane.
Let me show you. Think back to when you first met Taylor. Think back to 2065. You're on a train in Switzerland.
I'm heading toward downtown Zurich.
On Taylor?
That's him. Commander John Taylor. The first dead killer. The definition of determination. I was a rookie then. Fresh blood. There weren't many of us. There were more rumors about our division than actual recruits. They said we were engineered to be immune to 6115, that we couldn't get infected.
This was your first mission?
Yes. 5 years after the outbreak, most cities had at least one containment zone. The raid. There was a Qatardis terrorist collective. They were planning something big. Drops, I keep seeing. I saw them in coalescence too.
It is your mind trying to help you through your memories. Weapons, abilities, powers. Use them or don't, but they may offer you a temporary advantage. Where did the ass take you next?
We still have to get to the factory entrance.
Yeah.
The entrance was locked. We had to destroy a generator to get it open. That was around the corner, with more dead standing in our way. I had an arsenal in front of me, but Diaz made it clear. He told me to run point on the ground. He was curious to see me think on my feet.
In a way, he was acting as your training.
Diaz wanted me to earn the name Dead Killer. And there's really only one way you can do that. I had support that day, but when you're out there in the real world, you're on your own. No backup, no reinforcements. Just you and the undead. I'd show him I was worthy of the name. Cotarda's base of operations was just ahead. Once we were inside, we'd be able to figure out what they were planning.
Celine. What's happening? I can't...
Come stay with me. Come back to my voice.
I can't. I don't understand.
Tell me what happened.
I saw robots and they were ripping me apart. What's happening to me? What was I seeing?
It is a lapse. Your mind is wandering into the unknown. Your subconscious finding fears, dreams, doubts. Stay with me. Stay with my voice. You're still in the factory. You were about to make a discovery.
Wait. Yes. We were ready to breach, but it didn't go as planned. He was ready. I had to get him through. Our mark was going to release 6115 into the surrounding area.
Remember, walk before you run. You weren't alone. Who else was there? Taylor?
Taylor. Yes, he discovered our mark had just unleashed the virus into Old Town, turning civilians into the living dead. But Taylor didn't leave that day. No, he had Overwatch. He was our eyes in the sky. Sarah Hall, however. Sarah Hall, the team's intelligence expert, was with me. She had point. She found our mark. Apparently his supply of 6115 was 10 times what we initially believed. Enough to turn all of Zurich into a city of the dead. Hall had been with Taylor as long as Diaz. He practically raised her, trained her. He made her. With Taylor in the sky, Hall was our feet on the ground. She didn't have as much patience for fresh blood as Diaz. She was direct and focused. And right now, she was about to give me a lesson in target quality. This guy didn't mess around. He had DNI just like us. He was hijacking any robotics he could, sending them after us.
What happened when you caught him?
Our mark was bleeding out after that fall through the ceiling. Time wasn't on our side, and we needed information.
So what did you do?
I would do what Hendrix did in Coalescence. I had to interface with him, extract the information from his memories.
You make it sound cold. You would be diving into this man's mind. A dangerous task. A terminal task.
I know. But you have to make it cold. Detach yourself from the person. It was our first time performing this sort of interface, and Hall wanted to get that point across above all.
the time we tracked down the Catardus operations and they were putting up a good fight.
Who joined you in the tunnels?
Taylor oversaw the operation, but the lead on this was Peter Moretti, the last of Taylor's team, an explosives expert. He was the guy you wanted when you needed to blow shit up. He was damn good at blowing shit up, which made him perfect for the fight ahead. Fearing discovery, the Catardus Collective had an armada of undead and patrolling robotics guarding the facility. I won't lie, it's strange seeing Moretti like this, knowing what happens next. He was crucial to finding Taylor, to finding Deimos.
You mean the refineries in Cairo?
He had a pivotal part to play. He just didn't know it yet. What he knew then was the way to the hideout. He took point.
Yeah!
Katardis group had planted a biochemical bomb containing 6115 on a maglev train. They were going to detonate it in downtown Zurich. Their plan was to turn the whole city as we feared. Taylor said there wasn't much time, but I'd done good for all the on-the-job.
You didn't even need my push to the final memory. You connected events and arrived at the truth.
Now what happens?
Now we set things right. Through your mind, you realign the events as they occurred.
And by doing this, if I work with you and remember the events leading up to Zurich?
You will be able to open the gateway. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Let us finish here first.
I found the bomb car. The whole thing was wired up, primed to blow. There wasn't time. I couldn't disarm it.
So what did you do?
Remember how we can't get infected? Some of the rumors about us were true. That's why I was there. Why we make the sacrifice. I used my cybernetic abilities to reverse the polarity of the train car and... No. No, 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 no. I remember this place. What are they doing to me? Dr. Salim, what am I seeing? Taylor? Why can't I move?
You must let this go. Stay with me. Relax. Come back to me. Come back to the void. Can you hear me? Are you there?
I'm here. I'm back. I'm ready to continue.
Good. Now that you've begun conditioning, let's return to 2070. After coalescence collapsed, you were trapped in Singapore.
With quarantine zones unlocked all over the world, we couldn't raise WA Command. If we were going to escape, we had to improvise. We turned to the 54 Immortals. They were dangerous and unpredictable, but they were no enemy of ours.
Hendrix trusted them?
What choice did we have? If we wanted out of Singapore, we had to go through the biodomes. We had to go through the Immortals. Getting in was easy. Getting out would be another matter entirely. I don't know how the undead got in. A forgotten open gate. A child's mistake. A poorly nailed board over a window. It didn't matter. It was spreading fast. We were already outnumbered 20-1. The remaining humans scrambling away or locked in their homes.
Yeah!
We heard that familiar screech. Parasites, mutated creatures born out of 6115, were flying towards us. Shipping yard cleared. Cloud Mountain was just ahead. The server room at the top. We had a long climb ahead of us.
What happened in the server room?
By the time we got there, Gojulan encrypted her hardware, locking us out of the central server. Hendrix stepped in, but we were a few seconds too late. Damage was done.
Why did she lock you?
Sure, we won't. Hendrix had pulled all the data he could. I hoped it was enough. Our pickup was in position. It's time to get the hell out of here.
This Wraith telling you. It was like the malfunctioning robot you found in different quarantine zones. The kind targeting anything and everything as an enemy.
Just like that. Except on a much larger, more deadly scale. And this one was very interested in us. Command had an exit route, extraction set beyond the swamps. If we crossed the super trees, there were shipping docks where we could commandeer an airboat. It's easier said than done. Between the Flesh Eaters and that Wraith eyeing us, the Super Trees would be no walk in the park. We had to haul ass and stay out of sight. But they weren't our only concern. Winslow Accord picked up chatter ahead. Apparently, we weren't the only humans using the docks to escape. super tree was collapsing. The only safe route to the docks was up. Chatter confirmed that 54 immortals were scrambling to get out of the biodomes through the swamps. From the sound of it, they wanted us dead as much as the Flesh Eaters did. Looked like we were jumping from one bad situation into another. Hendrix commandeered an airboat and set the autopilot. We had undead on our ass, and more 54i ahead. And that rogue Wraith wasn't done with us yet. Virus. 6115 wouldn't stop this time. The Winslow Accord and CDP had been thrown into chaos. We'd lost Hong Kong, Berlin, and Cairo, and it was just getting started. What would come next? How the world would change? There was no way to be ready for that.
Five long, dark years. Opening the quarantine zones did exactly as we feared. And by 2075, what was a contained situation gave way to anarchy. Humanity's numbers had been reduced to a few hundred mil scattered across the globe. The undead had risen. Taylor was in the reminder of our inability to stop Armageddon. There was still a Winslow of hope. Our target was a Catartus colony. They'd taken over a refinery. It was a well-armed facility protecting them from the deadly world. Top priority was to cut off their comms and leave them in the dark. But first, we had to clear out their defenses. This was a routine sweep. Every time another sympathizer colony sprouted up, we'd squash it back down. As far as we were concerned, we were doing the world a favor. We moved on the array, but the undead sympathizers weren't going down without a fight. Our support detail needed a few moments to disable the array. Lucky for me, I had more hostiles to keep me occupied. Disabling the comms would take some time. Our support... I dealt with reinforcements.
station disabled, we had to get back to our burrow. The array was ahead. Bring it down, we'd be one step closer to eradicating this colony. With the comms disabled, we needed to get back in the air. With their comms jammed, the next step was to breach the control room to take back the facility. There was access ahead. I just needed to get through the flooded room in front of me. Our support detail insisted on coming with.
When you were swimming, something went wrong.
Our DNI. There was a malfunction.
What did you see?
I saw. I was drowning. I thought I heard.
This is not your time. Get back up. Do not trust him. Everything is not what it seems.
What did you hear?
Nothing. I couldn't make it out.
Get up.
Then I woke up. Someone pulled me out of the water. Someone saved me.
Saved you?
A guardian angel. Someone watching over me. My support detail. She got through somehow and pulled me out. She brought me back from the brink. She said it wasn't my time. My work wasn't done. I had to stop Taylor. I don't know how she knew. It didn't make any sense.
Did you know her? This woman?
No. I'd never worked with her before today.
And yet she knew about Taylor. She knew about what happened. And you're sure she was there?
What? Why? You think I made her up?
You yourself said your DNI systems were malfunctioning.
What? You gonna tell me I'm crazy next? I know what I saw. I did not make her up. I didn't fucking imagine her.
Did she have a name?
Of course she had a fucking name. The Guardian Angel. She said her name was Kane. She told me she'd help me get through this. She said we had to move. Control was beyond a server room ahead. If we were going to take the refinery from these dead sympathizers, we needed to clear it out. If we couldn't, it would be on to Plan B.
Plan B?
Plan bomb this shithole to hell. We prepped to breach, but it turns out our enemies planned ahead. The explosion blocked our path. We had to double back. It caught us off guard. But the noise also caught the undead's attention. We regrouped with our allies. That's Egyptian Army Lieutenant Ziad Khalil, friend of ours. He was durable, seasoned. He defended his home through undead wars. He wouldn't go down without a fight.
What was the plan?
Khalil would move on control from the exterior. I'd sweep the dead from the air. Our guardian angel accompanied me. She told me the answer to finding Taylor was on this refinery. Why she thought that. How she knew that. It was surreal. When Khalil took the control room, he found something on the security. Moretti was just below us. If we were gonna get him, we'd need to take a shortcut.
Shortcut?
A leap of faith.
Trust her. Find Taylor.
How was Hendrix coping with the change of plans?
He was upset. And why wouldn't he be? Command wanted our friends dead.
Cornered him. What did Moretti say?
He said that name. Same as Diaz. Deimos. He said if I wanted answers, I had to find Damian Bishop, a man we both knew from a past mission. Bishop could help stop Deimos. But first, I had to kill him. He kept saying, "This isn't me. This isn't me." He kept saying Deimos made him do it. I did our job. It did. We lost Taylor, but we had a lead. Moretti?
This Bishop that Moretti mentioned?
Damian Bishop, the man who found the cure. A vaccination to make 6115 victims human again.
A cure? Did it work?
It should have. Something was blocking it. Bishop had this theory. He believed somewhere there was an undead brain. A single creature controlling them as a collective hive. He believed that it somehow blocked the cure. We met him in 2065 when he made the breakthrough. News traveled fast. He and a few others were kidnapped. With the dead crawling all over, we needed a distraction. Something to keep the flesh eaters occupied so we could grab Bishop. We weren't dead killers yet, so we had to be a little more creative. And lucky for us, there were plenty of NRC birds in the sky, and the NRC's dead system still worked. Laser cannons built to auto-target any hostile aircraft.
So you created the diversion.
And Taylor's team prepped extraction. Unfortunately, it seemed our cover wouldn't last as long as we hoped. The remaining NRC noticed the radio silence from air traffic control and had sent soldiers to investigate. Command set exfil for a satellite station off base. We reset the dead system to target one of the automated planes circling above. Turns out the undead have a thing for giant explosions, like moths drawn to a porch lamp. And all we had to do was turn on the lights. Unfortunately, we couldn't exactly control the landing. Hendricks alerted Taylor the bird was down and the diversion in play. We took out the NRC and moved. Bishop was being held underground in the security station across the tarmac. Hendricks ordered weapons down. The base was crawling with NRC soldiers and undead. No need to draw anymore. We crossed the tarmac. The tunnel ahead led to the security station. Hendricks took out the guards. I hacked into the system to find Bishop.
Why were the NRC still at the base? It was being overrun.
They needed the cure. They kidnapped Bishop's whole team and would do whatever it took to get their hands on it. They'd torture these researchers till the dead broke down the door and ripped them all to shreds if it meant they could save their people. It wasn't personal. It was self-preservation. With the secret out about Bishop's discovery, he'd become the most wanted man in the world. The NRC... were just the first to grab him. It was every country for itself. Why do you think we were there? The Winslow Accord wanted the same thing the NRC did.
You can't rationalize anything when you're put up against the wall.
Nothing about this was rational. It was instinctual, animalistic, survival. He had been escorted to an interrogation room. We had to hurry. Behind us was an undead army. Once one got a whiff, the others would come running. Hendricks told Bishop who we were and that we had to move, but Bishop refused to leave without the other researchers, his friends. Our instructions were specific. Bishop was our priority. We didn't like it, but Bishop refused to leave without them.
It sounds like you were taking an awful risk.
He said for the cure to work, he needed them. They weren't expendable. Technically, we were.
In a way, you and the NRC were not so different in what you wanted and how far you were willing to go.
Our method was different. Our reasoning was not. No one wants to sacrifice themselves to save the world. But you like to think if the moment came, you'd have it in you.
Who was inside the cell?
Lieutenant Zied Khalil, member of the Egyptian army. Back in 65, he was a guard assigned to Bishop's research station. This was how we met. Hendricks cut him down and notified Taylor we were freeing the other hostages. Taylor said we didn't have the time. The base was swarming with additional NRC forces. They weren't letting their prize go that easily. There was a tunnel full of hostile soldiers between us and our exit. A cargo elevator ahead was the only way to the surface. No telling how close the dead were behind us.
Thank you.
The remaining NRC forces were waiting for us above. They weren't about to let their prize prisoner go. If it meant getting the cure and saving their families, they were willing to die for it. And they weren't the only ones. We'd never seen dead killers in action before. To them, another day in the life. Wait a minute.
Do not be deceived by his lies. Remember your past. Remember when you first met John Taylor. Remember the truth.
Wait, this is wrong. This can't be... ...artist uprising after I became a dead killer. But here I am with Taylor. And my limbs haven't been replaced yet. Why did you met Taylor with Zurich?
Focus. Need to complete. What was Taylor's plan?
We were still on for Exfil. But first, we had to blow the bridge. We followed Diaz. Both undead and NRC forces were converging on our position. Hall grabbed us after the hangar. She was to take us to Moretti, so we could blow the bridge. After the bridge, we were forced inside a comm center. Moretti took point. The rendezvous with Taylor was an APC garage just ahead. We could hear the undead screaming towards us. But that was all. A robot horde was moving in. Taylor needs some time to get the door open.
You were forced into the garage.
Taylor said Bishop was priority. After all, he had the cure. The rest were just collateral.
What did Taylor do?
He volunteered to take his team to get the others. We were to take Khalil and Bishop to Exfil. We got on the APC. Bishop was the most important man in the world right now. We had to get him to Exfil if it killed us. spun out and crashed. Hendrix moved Bishop into position. The drone evac was inbound. Once secured in the drop pod, it would return to collect. We just needed to hold back the Horde.
What happened?
Airspace was compromised. They had to pull out. Bishop was a priority. We heard Dave. He was inbound and told us to hang on. No. I can't do this. I can't. Live this again. No. Please.
I am sorry.
No, please.
If you wish to defeat death, you must. To save the world, you must relive this.
She died. Myself fade. It was over. That was the day I met John Taylor. That was the day I became a dead killer.
That was the day you met Bishop. The man who found the cure, before he died at the Cairo aquifers. Moretti told you to find him.
On Moretti's instruction, we sought him out. We told him what we knew, which at the time was just a name, Deimos. He didn't know much, just that Deimos was responsible for the outbreak, and that a safe house in Singapore had a dossier on the guy. So we returned to Singapore. Little did we know, Go Zhulan had taken the city, and somehow gotten the undead to obey her. If we were gonna get to the safe house, we'd have to go through them.